6, lesson 1, computer languages. So now, first of all, going through this chapter, let us study what is a language. According to you, what is a language? So language basically is a medium by which two people communicate with each other. Okay, now if suppose the language is same, both are knowing English language, then it's okay. But if suppose any one of the person is knowing some other language, like suppose if I am knowing English and the other person is knowing French, then it creates a problem. So the same thing happens when we deal with computer also. We know human language and computer know computer language. Now what is computer language? Computer language is actually the machine language. Computer language is actually the machine language which consists of 0 and 1. So if suppose we are giving any instruction to our computer, so it is converting it into 0 and 1 and understanding it. Now what is converting that language? That is the translator. So in this chapter, we will discuss about various types of computer languages, generation of languages, and the working of translator. So let's begin with computer languages. Now what is computer language? A language by which we can interact, a user can interact with computer. Now computer is a machine. Computer works on the instruction given by you. So whatever instruction you are giving is getting converted into machine language and getting executed accordingly. Suppose if you are doing double click on any item. So double click, computer doesn't know. But it knows that after double click, this code will happen. Means one code is going to computer's processor and it knows that okay, this code means that we have to open this folder. So this is actually conversion of any instruction given to the computer. In the same way, in IT firms, we are creating various softwares in various computer languages. Some are very efficient in Java, some are very efficient in C++. So they are creating their softwares in that particular languages. Now, there are various ways to say one thing. Like in English language, one thing can be said. The same thing can be said in Hindi also, the same thing can be said in French, but the meaning is the same. Same is with computer languages also. Like suppose in Java, if we have to take the input, the statement is different, but the meaning is same. In C++, the statement is different, but meaning is same. So every language has its own dictionary. Like English language, French language, Hindi language, they have their scripts. In the same way, in computer languages, every language has its own dictionary, its library, where all keywords are stored, and accordingly, we write the language and execute our code. Now coming to how many types of languages are there. There are two types. First is low-level language and high-level language. Now what is low-level language? Low-level language is that language which is dependent on machine. Means if I am executing any program with low level language, written in low level language on my machine, it will get executed here only. You cannot take that code to some other's machine and execute it. So that is actually what I meant by low level language. Now in low level language, we are having two languages. That is machine language, which is also called first generation language. And second is assembly language, which is also called second generation language. Now here we will discuss about various languages as well as the generations. So the first and the foremost and the basic language is the machine language. Now what is machine language? Which is directly used for communication by computers. Computers are using such type of languages and it comprises of 0 and 1 and nothing else. Okay, now this is a very basic language and it is also known as first generation language. Or we can call it as binary language because here we are using two numbers, that is 0 and 1. That's why it is called as binary language also. It is also called as first generation language. Now coming to assembly language. Now machine language is to be used by computers only. Now we come to a set of language or set of generations. people. Then these set of people can only go ahead with this type of language. Now these languages are actually using certain small codes. Like instead of writing full addition, their code is add. Instead of writing multiplication, we write MULT. So in this way, we have framed a particular code for a particular command. Like if I have to give the command to add two numbers 3 and 4, I will give ADD 3, 4 in this way. Like suppose I have to add two numbers, I will write ADD and here I will write 3 and here I will write 4 and I will press enter. As I will press enter, automatically the answer will come as 7. In this way, various commands have been made in this type, in this set of language. But this was very rare people were able to understand such type of languages and it was very difficult to learn. Now came the third generation of language, which was known as high level language, or which can be known as the machine independent language. Now here we started with the evolution of computers. Many sort of languages came into picture. Many people came in front to learn it, and there was a vast amount of people who were there in IT firms for creation of software, and from here the IT technology started increasing. The IT sector started increasing. Various types of software started developing. Why? Because many people came up for this. Why? What was so special about this language? So high level language is actually the English language. Like I am right now speaking in English and you are able to understand it. In the same way, high level language is also written in English language. There is nothing other language which you have to learn for high level language. Only the way of writing becomes different. Like suppose if a high level language C++ is there and suppose we are having Java. Now suppose if I have to take output or I have to print something in C++, then I will write cout and I will write the print statement in the inverted commas. And if I have to write the same thing to get printed, suppose I have to print A here, so I will write A. Now here if I have to write print A, then I will write system.out.print. And here whatever is to be written, I will write it inverted bracket. Now what you have seen here, what is the difference? In both the cases A is getting printed, only the way of writing is different. Like suppose in English if I have to write something, that then I will write English language, and if in Hindi I have to write the same thing, I will use Hindi language. The meaning of both the things will be same. Only the words will be different. Here I will be, for English I will be using alphabets and for Hindi I will be using something else. So in this way actually our computer, this high level languages are working. Now in the generation which we are, we need something which is very quick, very fast. So now we came into a generation which was known as fourth generation language, that is 4GL. Now what was 4GL? 4GL is something which is very close to human language, and with giving a certain command, only just writing a command or clicking somewhere at one or two places, we are very easily able to do the things we want to execute. There is no need to write one big sentences like this. Only we have to give a certain, we have to learn certain steps to execute that particular command and it's done. Like suppose for an example, if I want to create a database of my organization and I want to then retrieve the data accordingly. Suppose the ones who are having age greater than 45. So I have to just give a command and the data of all the people whose age is greater than 45 will be retrieved. So this is how 4GL is working. Now what is happening? It is getting converted to 0 and 1. Whatever language you will come across, we have to convert it to 0 and 1 because the only language which computer is understanding is 0 and 1 and nothing else. So when any language we are dealing with, they go to the processor and get converted to 0 and 1 as shown in the picture. They are getting converted into 0 and 1s. Then computer is understanding is whatever language we are dealing with, whether it is assembly language or high level language or 4GL. They all are going into a conversion process and getting converted to machine language. Okay, now this conversion process is done through translator. Now what is translator? A translator is a program which is converting high level languages to a low level language. Now when this high level language is converting into low level language, so it is understood by the machine that what we are trying to execute. Now whatever output is there, the output is then we are taking out the output or the result of that particular action and then we are converting back to a human understandable language. So whenever we are executing any program, we are seeing that the output comes in our language only. It doesn't come in computer language because human will not be able to understand what is going on when we are writing 0 and 1s. In the same way, we are having translators. So these translators which we are working on, they are actually of two types. One is compiler and another one is interpreter. Now what is actually compiler? To understand how compiler works and how interpreter works. Case 1 is that I am making you write 5 questions. Now after I have written those 5 questions, actually I have asked your copy back. You have given me, after writing all the answers, you have written the answers and you have shown me, given me back your copy. You have checked the copy, I have checked the copy and returned you back with the errors. I have notified the errors that line 1, line 2, line 3, line 4 are having errors. I have said you in the remark that please return back me the copy after rectifying the errors. You have rectified the error and you have again sent me back the copy. Again I found that second line and third line was not corrected. I have again send you back the copy and you have again returned me after correcting it. So this process of giving and taking back the copy will continue until and unless all the errors have not been rectified. Once the error has been rectified, I will give you a tick and will give you my signature and your copy is corrected. This is the output. This is the output. Okay, now we are coming to interpreter. Now what is case 2? When we are dealing with case 2, actually what we are doing? I have written from question 1 to question 5, I have written. After writing from question 1 to question 5, what I have done, I have written answer 1 and asked you to give me back the copy. I have corrected answer 1 and I have sent you back the copy. Then I have written answer 2, I have asked the copy back. So one by one I will write the answer, I will check that answer and give you back. This thing will happen, suppose in answer 3 I found any mistake. I will say first corrected, then only I will write answer 4. First you have corrected the error in answer 3 and then we move to answer 4 and then in the same way we have written answer 5 also. So this thing was done. So this is step by step. and compiler, what compiler is doing? Together. Means I have given you a code of 10 lines. It will convert that whole code. Wherever the errors will be, it will give you the list of errors at line number 1, line number 7 and line number 8 are having the error. Once they are giving me the errors, I rectify that error and again run that program. Again, if error will be there, it will be shown to me. Else, my program will get executed and I will get my result. Interpreter, what interpreter is doing? It will check first line 1, line 2, line 3, line 4. As soon as at line 4 it found an error, it will stop there. It will not move to line 5 until and unless you have not corrected the error at line 4. First you correct the error at line 4, now come to line 5. Then line 5, line 6, line 7, line 8, and then if no errors are there, again the whole code will be executed and you will get the result. So the working is same. Both are doing the same thing. Both are converting high level to low level language. But the mechanism is different. The compiler is converting it at once and interpreter is converting it one by one. The compiler will take less time and interpreter will take more time. But when we are having small codes, small sections of codes, then compiler is okay. But when we are having big segments of code, like we are having in IT firms for creating a software, because when we are creating a software, at that time the coding is more. So what we are doing? We are correcting that code using interpreter, because it will not move forward and it is very difficult to find. If you are using compiler, it will just show us the line number and it's very difficult for a person to find that, to locate that line if the code is more. So that's why at that places we are trying to use interpreter. So this is the way our whole programming is done. The basic sense of programming is to convert it into machine language successfully so that computer understands it. Once the computer understood our motive of doing this program, it will give you the output and again it will revert it and convert it back. So this was all about computer languages. I hope it was clear to you and thank you for watching this video. Have a nice day.